The name of our Nancy Becker and her Chicago address was found in James Earl Ray's pants pocket when he was captured after his latest prison break. That came out in a Playboy magazine article, an article which used many of Nancy's questions when she met with Ray inside the prison. There's a lie detector test involved in that story also, and Nancy joins us now with the latest on this development. Nancy?
Fahey, the nationally respected Chicago polygraph firm of John E. Reid and Associates gave James Earl Ray a lie detector test just a few days after his recapture. They asked him questions much like I asked Ray at Brushy Mountain Prison a month before. And people want to know, did you pull the trigger?
No.
Who did?
I don't know. I couldn't just be speculation, but I don't think we'd ever know all the details until the Justice Department makes public what they have declassified now, or classified, rather.
Were you ever offered a bounty to kill Dr. King?
No, I wasn't offered any bounties.
Were you ever paid a bounty for killing Dr. King?
No.
Could you kill somebody for money?
I doubt very much. Maybe self-defense, but I'm not sure I have the constitution for that type of operation.
In the opinion of the examiner, Ray was not telling the truth when he denied killing Dr. King and when he said he didn't know who did. The polygraph examiners determined he was telling the truth when he said he did not receive any money for shooting Dr. King. To summarize, Reid says its tests indicate Ray did kill Dr. King and that he did so alone. Ray's brother Jerry tells me there were trick questions. His attorney says the test was administered in a hot room while Ray was suffering from a headache and taking aspirins.
As a standard part of our procedure, we ask the person before the test if he's had any medication or how he physically feels at the time of the test. And James Earl Ray said he had no medication and he felt fine. So that if there was any indication at all he wasn't feeling up to par, we would have stopped any proceedings to make sure that he was suitable for the test.
How long did it take to take that test?
The entire testing probably was in the area of 2 to 3 hours at two separate sittings so that he was able to go out for lunch or have lunch between the examinations.
His brother tells me that there were trick questions, were there?
No, ma'am. All questions that we use for the test are reviewed with the subject, with Mr. Ray, before any testing is done. So he has an opportunity to refuse to answer questions or to explain anything that he feels would be appropriate.
And before the test, Ray did okay those questions. Ray recently told reporters from Playboy magazine that he had hoped in escaping he could make some sort of arrangement to turn himself in exchange for a trial. How would he have gotten to Attorney General Griffin Bell? When I was arrested, he said, they found two pieces of paper on me. One was a map of Tennessee, the other was the address of Nancy Becker. I would have made some kind of arrangement to contact Bell through her. Until you could get to her house, what would you have done? He answered, go to one of these Goodwill places or a run-down place where you don't look too conspicuous, going in tattered up. And will you try to escape again? I would if a wall fell down or something. And Fahey, I think that we should stress that the polygraph test is considered 85% accurate. It is, however, not admissible as evidence in court.
Right. You believe it?
I believe that there should be evidence presented in court. There never was a trial, and I certainly would like to see one.
Thank you, Nancy.